Hello guys, and what is going on? It is RR here, and welcome to the RR and GD podcast, episode 5. I'm back with the boy, GD.
That's me.
How are
That's
you?
That's me. I'm good. You?
How are we? I'm doing good, mate. I'm doing good. We're back. Episode 5, mate.
Episode 5.
We've made it to 5. We've got 10 more in us, I reckon.
10 more. Now I've got to do more thumbnails.
Yeah, then you've got to do more famies. So that's
what we do is change one number.
Change one number. Because, you know.
And sometimes two.
We don't make it hard for ourselves.
No.
Make everything easy for yourselves, and then hope the views come in.
That's the plan.
Speaking about views, thanks so much for all the support on episode 4, by the way. You guys really seem to enjoy that one. We got like 14 likes on that or something like that, so you guys smashed it. Comments as well. It's always good.
Keep that up.
Love a bit of interaction. A good idea is a good idea forever. If you missed that, if you didn't go all the way to the end of the podcast, then
you
missed out.
Because the only person who done it...
Pete, innit? There's only Papa Pete with a good idea is a good idea.
No one else put it, so therefore all. Nah, I'm joking.
Therefore,
we'll
lies.
We'll take likes and run on
I'm joking,
cheers,
yeah. Just like it, watch 5 minutes, fuck off, I don't mind. It's up to you, innit? But either way, we appreciate all the support on the last episode, it was absolutely amazing. It was just good. It's good, 25 subs as well now.
Yeah, 25
so
subs.
Cheers for that. That's like a quarter way to 100, man. That.
Yep.
We're at 100 and then we're quitting, by the way.
We are, that's basically
get
the
AdSense in, because...
Yeah. Ideally, the watch time.
Watch time.
Yeah,
so maybe.
How many subs is it to get it?
I think. I don't think it's 1,000 subs now?
Might be 1,000 actually.
Yeah, maybe
I'm
we'll get 1,000 subs and then just watch loads of stuff, please. That'd be great.
Yeah, because then we can get some ads on it, please.
Yeah, 8 minutes now as well, but that's a big change.
Talk about
that.
10.
There we go. 8 minutes instead of 10 minutes to get mid rolls.
Imagine like dragging it out. It's boring, isn't it? Because you know, like when you know, like you see, usually we're doing a 10-minute video. You know, they're doing it for the ad. Obviously.
Yeah, of course
I get it, right?
Yeah.
But then it's like it's always like that filler part where it's not.
Yeah.
It's just there.
It's just there, isn't it? Just there. Just there, and it's not good. I mean, there was a bit. I watched a Jackmate video. I think it might have been on his second channel, and I think the video clocked in at like 9:50, right? So he in post editing, he literally recorded himself 10 seconds and put it right at the end and put, well, you know why I'm here, stretching out to 10 minutes tonight. So, cheers, and he just sits there
why
drinking
not?
A cup of tea.
Why not? Yeah.
I mean, that's what he does for a living, so I don't blame him. Do you know what I mean? At least he's honest. But yeah, there we go. That's first topic done. It's not even a topic. We're not got
it
on
it.
Episode 5 was / kind of is meant to be about mine and George's favourite memories. But we're not going to do memories as such.
Like,
we're going to talk about
from
our lives, like personally. We're going to talk about our shared memories instead. And then talk about some topics later. So
I feel like for us, it just get a bit boring, wouldn't it? Like if I say, I met one of my good friends back in the day, you don't give a fuck.
Nah, I know your life story anyway. Do you know what I mean? You know my life story anyway. So
pretty much.
For
pretty,
us, it would be very... Maybe like 100 subscriber special. We'll like go through and pick shit apart and cry about stuff or something. But
just
episode
mean,
5,
really.
Innit? Do you know what I mean?
I mean,
ain't crying
we
in a thumbnail yet.
And then we've got to go and fucking cry.
I ain't doing it. You know what I mean? I ain't...
Fluxy babes. We love you.
We love you.
But we just couldn't do it in the end. We thought about it.
But... A good idea is a good idea
forever.
So remember that, all right? Just, we'll do it later, innit? But we're going to talk about a bit of memes. Excuse me. Well, by the way, me and George haven't long woke up. So we look like this. Do you know what I mean? We both look dead, to be honest with you.
I'm tired. To be fair, we did play SEP till about 4 in the morning.
Half four in the morning? Yeah, something like that. I didn't get to bed till about 5:45.
Same here. It's fine. I set my alarms like, fuck.
I'll tell you what I was watching, actually. I was watching, have you seen that twitch.tv/The Crown stuff that's been going on?
No.
No. Well, basically, I think what it is, they've picked, what they've done, Jericho has hosted it, right?
Right.
And then they've got three big streamers. Goldie's one of them. He's the coach, one of the coaches. Anne Munition. She's one of, Anne, you know Anne Munition? She's one of the coaches. She's cool. I follow her. And someone else. She ain't that big. Like, I don't know who she is. Or he. Is it a he?
It's a he.
But I can't remember who it is. But yeah, there's three coaches, right? And basically what they've done, they've picked three like upcoming Twitch streamers, right? That's what I mean when I get picked. Oh well, we'll move on. They've all got like I checked out their Twitters and that. They've hardly got like 200 followers on their Twitters and like they actually are like aspiring like streamers and that. And what they do is basically compete in these like in these games and different challenges, right? And whoever wins gets, like, some gifted subs and stuff. And they get like a space to like promote themselves in on the show. And I had like 100,000 viewers in it. And I was like, this is fucking really cool. Like, it's a bit cringy in places. Like, some of the games are a bit like, oh, you know what I mean? Like, there's one they were using, you know, them party things, that the whistles that you put in your mouth. And they go, they were using them to put balls in a hole in the IRL challenge. They never got the most balls in the hole. You know what I mean? It was quite fun to watch, don't get me wrong. It was like,
I mean, anything was a funny. Gift to subs at the end of
but
the day.
Yeah, I think, you know, I'm pretty sure they're playing for subs and exposure and stuff like that. And what they've done for this weekend, they've give, because they all did really well this week, they give every, like, each one of them, the free streamers, an hour on the Twitch front page this weekend in their streams.
That's really cool.
Isn't that cool?
I like that. Yeah.
I think that's a really, really cool thing. And like I say, Goldie is coaching one of the streamers who's, I think it's called BYN. His name's Brian.
Can you imagine that?
He's really cool. Like, he's dead humble. Like, this BYN guy's like dead humble. Like, they all got, like, given a chance to, like, promote themselves at the end. And the first one's called Chelsea Bites, and she's a bit hyped up. She's like, yo, come over to my stream. We do our, we get, you know, we're amazing, dude. And she gives, like, this whole speech, right? This BYN guy is just like, yeah, man, we're clapping cheeks. Come watch me. I was like, that's brilliant. I'm going to go watch him at some point. But, yeah, I think I dropped him a follow. But, yeah, it's just really cool. I thought that was a really cool thing. It's slightly off topic. That's not on it, but.
Kind of cool.
I forgot about that. I just wanted to tell you about it. But yeah, twitch.tv/crowd if you want to go check that out. I can't remember when the episodes are. They have got a Twitter where they announce everything. But yeah, Tucker hosts it. And Tucker's just Tucker, and he's just funny. he was a part when he was like, and now we're going to go over to this section. And it took like 20 seconds, and it was just his face.
Brilliant.
And it still worked. And he was like, maybe not then.
God. It didn't work.
It's weird because they've got like a whole production team behind it who do like all the streaming side of it. And they like get notes on what to say, like pop up through, because obviously they can't be all together in a studio. So they're all doing it with green screens and that. And it's really weird. It's really cool how they've done it, but really weird at the same time.
Yeah.
Like, it's obviously took big brains to sort that out. But, you know, it's really cool though. One day, hopefully, indie kids on there.
Hopefully. So,
and you'll see my Spider-Man poster in the background. And I'll be like, if you like Marvel, I'm your guy. I'll brand it. I will literally brand it, the whole thing.
Can we just point something out a sec?
Go on, what's up?
Right, so, you know, I always go on about, I got paid.
Yeah.
I thought my furlough ran out last Friday.
You've been paid again?
Yeah.
I got paid today.
I'll take that. Because it said on the thing that furlough finished, yeah? And my dad was like, there's no way they can just, like, not get in contact with you and not pay you because it's not your fault, because there's no work, yeah?
Yeah.
So why are they just going, you're not
getting it? A bit weird, isn't it?
So my dad, I was like, but I'm not getting it, Dad. He's like, but you are. So my dad was right. Love you, Dad.
Love you, Ian. Gotta love Ian.
Cheers, so, Dad.
That's a positive then. There you go.
That was good. I didn't expect to get paid. I was like getting
George still on the furlough.
I know, and it's
still on the furlough. It's the 10th of July, and what's happening on the 25th, George? Because you're buzzing about this. I know you are.
Zoo.
No, 25th. We literally spoke about this about 10 minutes ago. You're really looking forward to going back to this place that you've never been to in your life on the 25th, because they're opening up again.
Oh, yeah. Are we getting out of the way first?
Yeah, we might as well. You're talking about furlough. Let's get it.
Took me by surprise.
I'm chucking them in. I'm chucking topics at you. You know what I mean?
I'm like, fucking Jesus. What's he on
about? You're looking down the list. PS5 covers? Fuck. What's he on about?
It's coming out. So basically, if you didn't know, right, gyms and pools to reopen in England this month, right? And it's 25th of July. It's opening.
Yep.
Yeah?
Yep.
Outdoor pools can reopen from the 11th of July, and indoor gyms, pools, and sports facilities may reopen from July 25th.
Which is really good news for me, because I'm going to Centre Parks end of September.
Yeah, because then you can get to go to the
get to go on the pool and that. So
that's sick.
On the rapids.
And it says, So hang on. From July 11th, which is tomorrow, operas.
My what?
Dance.
Yeah.
Have I read that wrong? I might have done.
Operas. No, operas. Hall, that shit.
Yeah. Dance and music studios in England can put on an outdoor performances. Beauticians,
oh, I did see that, yeah.
Tattooists and tanning salons can, in England, can reopen from the 13th of July.
You're buzzing with a tanning.
Indoor gyms, swimming pools and sports facilities.
George is topping up his tan next Friday. He can't do the pod next Friday. He's topping up his tan.
I love a tan, mate.
He can't do
as
it.
You can see.
I'm going to get a message. I've got a feeling. I'm going to get a message. Me and Jay down at tanning beds for the day.
Right? The thing is, where I live, there isn't that far from a tanning place.
That's why you're so orange. Q orange filter. Get it on.
I'm a joke.
Maybe next week. Maybe next week. So 25th.
To be honest,
everything will be open by 25th, pretty
25th,
much.
25th, basically. So yeah, hopefully.
Yeah, you can't work yet. So
yeah, I can.
What's that?
Because now I see it, I'm assuming they're doing it the way of people have done their induction, the people that are there, and they're doing whatever days they can.
Mm-hmm.
And the people that just missed out are just still getting furloughed until
further notice, really,
they can get more. Like, they have an idea of, like, how many more people they can get in a warehouse, maybe?
Yeah, maybe.
That's the only thing I can think of. Because I can't... They've not let me go, obviously.
See, this is the thing, though. I don't get it. They haven't kept you in loop at all.
No, like, because the last real message they sent me was something to do with it's going to be opening.
Yeah.
Yeah. This was on the 3rd of June, by the way.
Yeah.
We've been informed that the M&S DHL, that's where I work, who cares, right? Right. Basically, date's not confirmed yet. If you're interested in coming back, please confirm. Yeah. So I did.
That's the way. M&S DHL. That's where I work. Who cares?
I don't work there anymore. Do I much? Dear. But you know.
Yeah.
And then I told him that I'm like willing to do shit. And then like last Tuesday, he told me, "Oh, thanks for letting us know and that." And that's it.
That's it. See, that's weird, isn't it? That's weird. But yeah. So the 25th, everything will be open. If you guys are a gym head. If you want to get on the fucking roids, I mean, I'm not saying all gym heads are roid heads, so don't come beat me up, because you're probably bigger than me. But, you know, get on the fuck. I'm going to go, I think. I'm going to get guns. Yeah, I reckon I'm going to go for a day. You know what I mean? Like I did last time. Do you remember that? When I went to gym, just before they all start closing. Went with Holly, didn't I? Because Holly's been going, isn't she? Like, really religiously.
Oh, yeah, she has been. Yeah.
She's been going a lot. She goes, like, twice a week. And they close.
I remember my dad used to go every Sunday. Right?
Did he?
So come home, right? I'm like, Dad, what? Oh, I just did length in the pool. Love you, Dad.
Oh, dear. Love that. But yeah, that's good news for me because of Centre Parks, really. That's all I really care about, to be honest.
That's kind of cool, yeah.
That's good for me because now I don't have to worry about that shit. I mean, Centre Parks are doing quite a good thing anyway. They're letting you know 2 weeks before if anything changes. And they'll either schedule you another week, like, further on in a year or next year.
Yeah, that's cool.
Or
give you
a refund. It's totally up to you. So that's pretty cool. They're doing that. So, yeah. I mean, it's cool anyway. But yeah, we're going to go definitely 100%. Cause
I mean, we're supposed to be going to Blackpool in September.
Yeah.
It's not quite the same, but it's Blackpool. I haven't been in such a long time.
Yeah.
Quite looking forward to
top
it.
Top of the tower. Come on.
For my father's birthday.
They love that.
You know?
Happy birthday in advance.
Yeah.
Won't be a pod that week, probably.
Yeah. I think we go on the. I want to say we might go on a Friday, so
we'll have
to do it on a Thursday again.
That's what we're doing next week, because I'm going to zoo next Friday.
I want to see giraffe pics. Can we get them on screen?
We'll get them on.
The time after.
For the pod. Yeah, I'll get them on. Went to the zoo. Ba-ding.
Went to the zoo. This is a pic of the giraffe.
There we go.
As long as I get giraffe Snapchats or whatever,
I don't care.
Or if it's just, I don't care where it is, as long as I see a giraffe.
I will put it somewhere.
Having a smile.
It'll be just tongue out.
Purple. That's me. Yeah,
purple tongues. Should we talk about how we met? Should we get into a topic?
Yeah,
riffing a bit, aren't we? Let's get on.
It's not boring.
It's not boring. It's good. This is good. Shit. We're talking a lot.
Right. I mean, okay.
Where do you want to start? Do you want to start or do you want me to start?
We can start with...
Me and George met.
Me and RR.
Me and GD.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was like...
A weird
meeting. Back in the day. So what was that? FIFA...
12. Yeah.
Wasn't it?
FIFA 11, 12? 12, probably, most probably.
It'd have been
2011.
I'm assuming you got. Yeah, 2011.
Because FIFA 12 would have been out in 2011, been out in September, wouldn't it?
Yeah. So I mean, I would have just started my YouTube channel as well, because I started in 2011.
Yeah.
I started in September. Yeah, so I did. Fucking hell, I thought about that.
September.
Yeah, that's cool.
See?
So I wasn't big back then, I'm joking.
I wasn't big, not now, but oh well.
Not now.
Still getting views though, just upload.
I've started.
Ah,
I'm not going to say it.
Mr. Start is back.
Come on. I'm not going to say it.
Go on.
So yeah, basically, me and you, we obviously must have got, do you remember YouTube messages back in the day?
I
used to get an inbox.
Yeah, inbox. What happened to them? Why did we get rid of them? What happened?
Why? They were cool.
They were good, right? I liked them.
Same.
Me.
We obviously got a email slash inbox.
Inbox, yeah.
From Just FIFA TV.
Just FIFA TV, which was a community channel back in the day. And if you don't know what, because I guess a lot of people won't know what a community channel is, really. Do you know what I mean? Like, we are old school. We are. Basically, a community channel was basically a place where, obviously, this one was Just FIFA TV, but it could be based around any game. They basically farmed out smaller content creators and provided them a platform to grow, pretty much. And you could do up your own uploads on there, make videos specific.
It was basically specific to the channel. Like, upload a squad builder and then upload the same one.
To your channel, yeah.
You have to do, like, an actual separate exclusive video for them. Yeah. Which is fair enough, because you can just shout it out on your video anyway.
Yeah.
Like, the video you're going to do on your channel, so.
Yeah, it's like doing a brand deal.
Kind of, you just don't get paid for it.
Yeah, you just don't get paid for it. You get exposure instead.
A bit of exposure and, like, you know, you might get the odd sub or two from somebody else that's in the community.
Yeah.
So, like, you know, you just make friends.
Well,
this is how we met.
Yeah,
so.
How we met. Well, to be fair, it did work pretty well for us, because I think mine and your videos are a few of the highest viewed videos on that channel, right?
Yeah. If I go on Just FIFA TV now.
Just have a little look. But yeah, I'm pretty sure I hit two videos with like over 1K. You hit one over 2K or something like that, didn't you? Something like that.
Yeah.
So, for like a budding content creator.
For you.
Go on.
If I can fucking sort it out. Right, so for you, your squad review.
My Jermaine one.
Yeah, Jermaine one. 1.4K views.
Yep. Deez. Take that. Thank you.
And your cheeky cheap informs.
Mm-hmm. What a series.
1.7K.
Yep.
Then Beastly informs. The exact same. Just one's beast and one's cheeky cheap.
Yep.
That only got 143.
A bit sad.
But that was only a 2-minute video, right?
Nah, that's wild, isn't it? You know what I mean? I'm not pushing for that ad. Not pushing for the ad. Tell you, fucking hell.
Then for me, it was my BPL squad builder with 619 views. Then my Borussia Dortmund squad builder with Naldo at centre back. Wasn't at Dortmund. 2K views.
2K, yeah.
And then my Premier DMX squad. Fucking
bombed
awful.
That, did, didn't it? That
bombed. 150.
Yeah. So we both had two good ones and then one shit one, really, didn't we?
Yeah, yeah.
But yeah, like I say, it's a really good stepping stone back in the day. Community, everyone was doing a community channel vid at some point, weren't they? Like, there was COD ones, there was fucking Let's Play ones, there was all sorts, FIFA ones, all sorts. Football Manager, I'm pretty sure there was a Footy Manager one knocking about at one minute. I'm pretty sure there was one, literally, that was, what was it called? Like, FIFA Pack Daily?
Yeah, no, that is, that because Just FIFA
It was
went
the same guy,
FIFA,
right?
Yeah, same guy, yeah.
Yeah.
Same guy.
And they literally just uploaded FIFA packs daily.
Yeah, basically.
Pretty much.
It's not been daily because it's been 7 years. I'm on the channel.
I'm still waiting. I've got notifications.
Still waiting.
On.
I might put a comment on. Still waiting.
Still waiting. When's episode
for,
two?
The FIFA 13 Ultimate Team pack opening. I'm waiting for episode 39, ideally.
Love it. I love it. But yeah, like I say, like that. So yeah, me and George met through Just FIFA TV, which is a community channel.
Based around FIFA. It's a weird one.
We don't actually remember initiating a conversation together, but
no,
we're pretty sure.
Unless we had like, it must have been Skype.
A group chat on Skype, right?
A group chat on Skype where we must have been in a Skype group for Just FIFA TV, and we must have started talking from there. And we obviously added each other, and ever since then, well, I don't remember. See, I would love to go back and look at that.
See, that's the thing, innit? I would like to go back and wish I had my channel still. Because I deleted my channel. Like, if I didn't delete my channel, my XAGMX97X channel, there's probably a video where I'd have spoke about meeting you. There probably is. Like, I think I know for a fact that I did
probably.
A video just talking, being like, oh, I've met this guy called George, could do this video together. Do you know what I mean? But that's you, George. That is.
Got a podcast.
But yeah, that's how we met. I mean, a lot of people probably do know that from watching the streams and that. But if you didn't know, that's how me and George met, through YouTube.
Just FIFA
grinding
TV.
Back in the day, FIFA videos. We were both really passionate about it then. FIFA and making videos. We actually
cared
then. Obviously, I only care about streaming.
You only care about streaming. Whereas me, I feel like since I'm more on the YouTube side of it, Streaming's a bit more harder for me.
It is.
It's not harder. It's just like I get bored, don't I, very easily with
you
games.
You do, yeah.
So if I stream for 2 hours, I'm like, oh, I'm bored now.
Yeah.
I don't want to play any games. I'm just going to end the stream.
Yeah.
Whereas you don't get bored.
I don't. I don't know when what I it is, bored. Man. I've always been better at streaming, though. Like, even when I was doing YouTube, I was streaming. Like,
yeah, I know, yeah.
Always streaming on Twitch, like, or on Justin.TV back in the days, boys. but yeah, like, I was always a streamer, I think. Like, I used to find YouTube videos hard. Like, I'm really bad at getting my point across in a 2-minute video. Do you know what I mean?
So am I.
Yeah, true. But yeah, I'm really bad at getting what I want to say across in a short amount of time, whereas if there's a stream, I can do it over a certain amount of time. We could get into the topic. That's why I like podcasts, because we can get into it and we can, you know, delve into it and we can pick it apart and stuff. And that's why I think I like streams more, because you can have more of a debate and you get that instant feedback. Like, as simple as that is, and that's a lot of reasons why big streamers like streaming. You just get instant feedback. Like, if chat don't like something, they'll say straight away, like,
yeah,
why are you doing this? What are you playing here? What is this? You know what I mean? Like, as much as they might be trolling sometimes it's true. And it's like, okay, I'll change up, you know? Learn from your mistakes. Whereas on YouTube, I think it's too gradual for me. I want to be like, bang, bang, bang. Yeah, I don't want to be upload a video.
Not many people then really watch the video. And then when they do, they're like, fucking hell.
Yeah.
But I'm going to say good video anyway.
Yeah.
And it's like, come on.
It's really, really hard to get honest feedback on YouTube. It really is. Like,
yeah.
Because no one watches a whole video.
No, I don't really either, to be honest.
No. The only people I watch whole videos on is you.
Ah, oh, fuck off. You don't watch all my videos. That's a lie.
That is not a lie, though. I used to. So, Primo. Swindon. You just love that. I'm a fan, all right? I'm a fan. I'm a fan and a friend. Look at you, look. Brilliant. Ryan likes me. He does.
He does. I don't know why.
But yeah, that's how we met. So I don't really know where it went from there. Probably made a video together, right? Or stream together, maybe?
We definitely streamed together, like, FIFA 13 days.
100%. Definitely. We did pro clubs and that with Jed.
Pro clubs, yeah. I'm not even going to say anything else. We played GTA a little bit.
We did.
On 360 days.
Yeah, 360 days. You met Reese first, right?
I met Reese because I remember I was streaming some Black Ops Zombies. Mm. He didn't even, like, he was trying to get into zombies at the time.
Yeah.
He was like, oh, can I play with you? I'm like, sure, why not? Like, whatever. Yeah. So he's obviously a fan.
Yeah.
He's obviously a fan.
Fan first, friend second.
He's like, oh my God, do you know what I mean? And then, like, just started becoming friends like that.
Yeah, and then you introduced me to him, and then we became friends, and then that was the trio for a bit, wasn't it?
Trio for a bit, and then
I've just scratched my eye, by the way, and it's gone really red, so I do apologize.
No. That's not good. Yeah, so it was like me, you, Reese for a bit, wasn't it?
Yeah.
That was how it worked, and then
that's it.
Then you went your separate way for a bit.
I did, yeah. I started concentrating on music.
Yeah,
because I had this weird thing where I think my big mistake obviously was deleting my X97X channel 100%. I had like 1.5k subs and it was buzzing. And
I'm pretty certain I know your reason, but I'm not gonna say.
Go on, I guess.
I don't want to say it.
Message me.
I will. Not now. Later.
Ah, okay. Well, that's made all.
Go on, do it. All right, tell me, and I'll be honest with you and see if I actually thought.
Well, because it was around the time me, Eddie, and Kieran were all doing it at school, and there was one tutorial lesson where Eddie got his video shown in front of all the class, and he got dead embarrassed, and, like, he was, like, flipping out, and he deleted his YouTube channel, and then Kieran did the same, pretty much, and then I was the only one doing it. But I was good at it, so no one could really take the piss, but they were still trying. And I felt like I was getting a bit bullied, so I panicked and deleted it. Shouldn't have done it. If I wasn't young, then I wouldn't have done it. If it was me now, I'd been like, well, fuck you guys. Yeah. I'm successful,
like,
here. Do you know what I mean?
For me, it was like not many people. Like, people knew, but never really took the piss.
Yeah.
Until, like, there was, like, when I went to college. Like, one of my tutors put it on the screen. So I did walk out in college. Because I know it's like, I'm 16 then?
Yeah, but still.
But, like, that's still, to me, like, especially when people, like, when I was in the business side of it, when I do business studies, I'm like, But then they didn't really take the piss. They were more saying, like, do you get money from it and stuff? And back then I did.
Yeah, same here, yeah.
And, like, they were like, well, it's not a bad idea.
Yeah. I remember.
Because you're creating video content, and if people like it, they like it, innit? It's up to them. And if you're going to get paid for it and it's a little bit of money on the side, you're only 16.
Yeah.
They were quite, like, it was embarrassing to begin with, but then it was actually really nice about it at the end because...
Yeah.
College, innit? It's a bit different. Like, there wasn't like 16-year-olds. There was, like, you know, like 20-pluses and stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
So,
I mean,
like, they were actually pretty nice about it.
I think it was especially hard for me because I was probably about 14, 15 when it happened. And it was at that point when no one really... Like, people watched YouTube videos, but no one really watched gaming YouTube videos. It was still new.
Yeah.
It was still a really new concept. And, like, people asked me, did you earn money from it? I was like, yeah. Like, I was partnered with Fullscreen. From like 900 subs onwards, like
with Yaush,
so. Yeah, you were, but yeah, they're gone.
But then
they bought out.
Fullscreen
bought them out, didn't they?
Yeah.
So yeah, I partnered with Fullscreen. I remember getting mum and dad to sign the because obviously it's too young.
Yeah,
to say
I'm,
yes.
My dad was there. My dad had to do it for me.
Yeah, right? I remember them signing the contract and everything, and started earning a bit of ad rev, you know.
Because I had to do a Skype thing with some guys.
Yeah, I remember. I remember that because you were dead nervous.
Yeah.
I
don't know why I was nervous.
You
about
were
it,
so nervous. Like,
I think it was just because it was at, like, a stupid o'clock in the morning. Because it's like.
Except
American,
aren't
it? Yeah. But luckily it was on a weekend, so it was okay.
Yeah.
But, like, I'm thinking to myself, like, I was sat there and I'm like, Dad, don't come in. I'm going to be asleep.
Yeah.
Makes sense. But then all it was, and you don't have to say anything. You just had to listen to what the guy had to say.
Yeah.
And then it was literally, if you wanted to talk to people about your channel, you can.
Mm.
But what's the point? Because they were all like COD anyway. Back then.
There
was a FIFA guy there.
Yeah, well, so that was when they first started developing Yao Sports, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So then, I used to love it, man, because I used to like go fucking hell. I get to have like links on my channel. Do you know what I mean? You know, where you can like put your Twitter and you can like click the Twitter. You know what I'm about?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
That was cool back then.
That was cool. That was a
feature.
If you're
a partner, that was, oh, sick.
That was a feature, wasn't it?
And, yeah, that was really cool.
Yeah,
stuff.
I remember getting, when I got signed by Fullscreen, I feel like I wasn't aware enough to take it seriously. I don't know. I just sort of did it. I made a shit ton of videos. I made money from it. Was buzzing. Then, obviously, when I deleted everything, that fucked everything. Because then I remember emailing them later, being like, I accidentally deleted my channel. Like, it is me, I can prove it. Please give me my partnership back.
Is that what you actually...
Yeah, but... Oh, something along them lines. They weren't that beggy, but... Oh,
bless.
But yeah, like, that fucked it for me. I mean, obviously, Fullscreen are massive now. So... I mean,
yeah, they are pretty big, yeah.
So, if I'd have kept going, never know, do you? But one of them, innit? One of them. But yeah. Yeah, well, I don't know where... Well, we must have done some streams together, done some FIFA vids together.
Then you obviously went away.
I went off to do some music stuff. But we got close before that.
We were closer, yeah. We got closer because we were like... I'm not sure because I think you still try to try... I think you still try to stream with your Roxy, yeah?
Yeah.
And then I think we was going to meet up anyway. And I was like, well, I'm going to upgrade to my HD60 to what my Elgato, my old one.
Yeah.
Which is obviously you now upgraded yourself.
Oh, yeah, I've got 60S now.
Yeah. Yeah, alright. Same as me then. Right, so you come to Swin, and then I give you my Elgato, and then ever since then, you've stayed.
Yeah.
So in a way, chat,
George's,
wasn't
for
me.
George's fault, I'm here. Really?
Yeah.
If anything goes wrong, blame him.
Yeah.
But yeah, like, when was that? It was 2 years ago now, right? 2 years ago?
Yeah, just over 2 years.
Just over two years ago.
Here we go.
Yeah, just 3 years? About that, because 2 years ago would have been...
Oh,
World
2 years
Cup.
Was...
So...
3 years, then.
3 years. 3 years ago you did that, and I've been streaming pretty much ever since, really. Apart from my little break last year. Before I come back this time.
Yeah.
But that was only 2-3 months, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, like we say, we don't really know how... We just got close. Like, there's no, like, amazing story behind this. We met on YouTube. We Josh FIFA TV, we grinded YouTube together, we made videos together, we streamed together, got close, started trusting each other, like,
that's
started talking about real life, and then we're best pals. Like, that's simple
that's
as
it.
That, innit?
That's it.
That's it, innit? And now we're together still, all these years later. And we've met twice since, so.
Yeah.
I mean, we have seen each other in real life.
It's good, isn't it? Weird,
and
but
he
cool.
Is, and he is a beautiful human being, and he did hug me, so...
You were more taller than I originally thought.
More taller.
don't know why. I was like, fucking hell.
Dear. I'm a bit of a beast.
You are cool. There was me in my swim jacket.
Hello. He walked up to me, right? He goes, hey, guy. I'm joking. You imagine?
You put your arms around me first.
I did. I initiated
the
hug.
You did. Then Holly was like, stood there, like.
Yeah, awkward. I got to deal with these bromancing the whole time. Fuck's sake. But yeah, that's it. We've been rambling for 30 minutes about how we met, and that's pretty much it. Bit of a trip down memory lane.
Do you know what I mean?
We've got to get going now. We've got topics. We've only got an hour and 20 minutes left on Buzzsprout until a payment comes out again in 4 days. So, do you know
what I mean? Cheers,
next thing, PS5 covers got released. Or a teaser of a cover. The Miles Morales cover. It's white and black.
It's got a white fucking...
white top.
Top bit.
Black PS5 bit.
Black, yeah.
Looks good.
Kind of cool, isn't it?
It does look good. It looks clean, looks cool. Excuse me. Matches. Hello? Oh my god. Matches the console very well. So, there we go.
It looks good. It looks quite nice.
Little bit of news.
There isn't much to say about it.
If you want to go look at it, at PlayStation.
At PlayStation. I put the Charlie Intown one in there because that's what I saw first.
Yeah, or it's in gaming news on my Discord. It's up to you, isn't it?
But it is legit.
It's legit. It looks good, clean, happy days. Next.
Looks good. Yeah. Right.
What's next?
Now,
what are we delving into?
See, look, in a way, do we go football or do we go...
I think we should get football out of the way.
Yeah.
Yeah, let's do it. Because, you know, Chelsea over there.
See, the thing is, right...
Not, though, is he? Swin.
I'm Swin through and it, right? But, like, come on.
He's got a Premier League team.
We've got a Premier League team.
Swin were never this good, so...
No, exactly.
He didn't have anything to look forward to.
I picked Chelsea because of my stepdad at that time, but he's cunt, so move on. So basically, the Champions League draw got released today, whatever you want to call it.
Yeah, draw.
Basically, Chelsea are either we're not going to, obviously, because we're 3-0 down against Bayern in the first leg, and we've got to go to the fucking what's it called?
Allianz,
isn't it? That's
Allianz, Simpez.
Yeah, we've got Napoli or Barca, so that's a waste of time.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing much to really say about it. We're not going through.
It'll probably be
a Barca Bayern quarter final. So
yeah, I reckon play the kids, boys. You know what I mean? Second leg, put the kids out.
Nah.
Give them a run on it because you're not going to get back from a 3-0 deficit against Bayern Munich in their home ground. Just saying, they got 3 away goals. For fuck's sake. Yeah. So that's you done. but yeah, there we go. That's Chelsea out of the Champions League. The Europa League draw obviously got announced as well. A bit more positive. This is from me. We're already 5-0 up against LASK. And then we've got a chance of getting Copenhagen or Istanbul Basaksehir. And I'll take either of them, to be honest with you. Preferably, probably Istanbul. I think Copenhagen are a bit of a better team. But either way, I'm confident we'll beat either of them in the next round. So I'm pretty happy to be there. I think we've got a really, really good chance of winning the Europa League. I really do.
Because who else, you got Sevilla in there, haven't you?
Yeah, Sevilla in there. I mean, Wolves are in there.
It's not Roma, is it?
Roma in there.
Because isn't it Roma and Seville, they've
got to play each other.
Or playing each other
Yeah, playing
now,
each other,
or
yeah.
Like,
I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, that's... Yeah.
So one of them
that's
are
annoying.
Gone. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
one of them are
annoying.
Gone.
Ideally, you'd like to think Roma's going to get to the final, right?
Yeah, I'd have thought so. Like, I don't know what the first leg is. I don't know what they're saying.
I can't remember.
So yeah. we're just riffing here, to be fair. But yeah, you'd have thought Roma in the final. Are Inter Milan still in? Or are they Champions League?
I don't know.
I have no idea.
I have no idea.
I've not done my research at all. I thought I did, to be fair. But yeah, that's the Europa League draw for United and Chelsea. Obviously, we're not really going to go in depth with other teams because we don't really care, to be honest, unless we're playing against them. To be honest,
which we will be
at some point. So
no, I don't even want to be in a Discord call for that. I can't. Bother. What's point? Because there's fucking four against one.
Yeah, we've got Chelsea in the FA Cup. When's that? Not next weekend. We're going to
19th?
Next weekend then, yeah. Next Sunday, innit?
Next Sunday, yeah.
Oh, I've got that Sunday off. Ooh, baby, let's go. Love that. But yeah, so we're going to talk about your
we're going to talk
remaining
about the running,
games.
Basically.
The running. There is four games left. Who has Chelsea got?
Theoretically... Yeah, in the Prem, but there is... Yeah.
Four games left in the Prem.
Right, so Chelsea have got Sheffield United.
Yep.
Away.
but...
Anymore.
A bit hit and miss, old Chef, in a minute.
Norwich at home.
You'll beat them, easy.
Liverpool away.
You'll lose.
Wolves at home.
You'll lose. No, I'm joking. You've got hard running.
Ideally, really? I...
Well, how many points do you reckon from there?
So three... See, look, I don't mind dropping points to either Wolves or chef.
Yeah.
If, like, if it's a draw, then it's whatever, isn't it?
Hmm.
But we can't lose any of these games, ideally.
Yeah, I mean, if you lose them, you're bottled
it. But then if we, let's say if we do beat Sheffield United and Norwich,
Which I
and
think
we lose
will.
Liverpool.
Yeah.
Then it's like, all right, that's fair enough. We get 9 points then because we want to beat the Wolves.
Yeah.
So, I sort of predicted 10, but I'm more likely to be 9 because I'd like to think we beat Sheffield United. I'd like to think we beat fucking Norwich. I'd like to think we beat Wolves.
Yeah.
But then saying that Wolves are a bit dodge.
They're always
United,
a bit
so...
of a bogey signing, sorry, didn't they? You know, mate, them and Chef. You've got a bit of a hard running, in my opinion. I think
a little bit
of a hard one. Obviously, it's a bit of a race for top four. Slash, well, for us, I reckon we're aiming third, you know. Like, we're 2 points off, aren't we? You're one point off Leicester and two points off Chelsea.
Yeah, 2 points off Chelsea, one off Leicester.
So, we've got big chance of getting top three here. And we've got Southampton, Palace, West Ham and Leicester to go.
To be fair, Southampton's going to be a little bit tough. That's the new real
thing. They're a bit in form.
Southampton and Leicester, that's it.
Yeah, they're a bit in form, Southampton. But I think we've got the quality to bypass them, to be honest with you. Form we're in, do you know what I mean? I reckon, 12 points, in my opinion. I think we'll beat Leicester as well. I don't know.
I can see us... You'll probably leapfrog us to third, and we'll probably get fourth.
Yeah, I mean, that's...
Leicester's running's hard, isn't it? Because they've got Spurs,
us, Bournemouth and Sheff. So,
yeah.
Bournemouth are fighting for points. Sheffield United. Do you know what I mean? Spurs
Tottenham,
are Spurs.
Tottenham, shit house.
Exactly.
And then
us. So,
yeah.
They've got the hardest one out of us three.
Ideally, for a Chelsea fan, you would want at least a draw in that game for Leicester against you.
Yeah, against us, yeah. But I don't, yeah. I think that'll be a game either team wins. I don't think it'll be a draw. Because Leicester are going to go all out. It's last game of the season.
Because it depends, like I said to you, it depends on if Spurs beat Leicester the game before.
Yeah, then they've got to go.
Then they're going to need to get the points, right?
Yeah, 100%. We're going to want them anyway.
Because
form we're in. So, yeah, it's a tough one. I mean, it's just really... I think it's the tightest it's been. But I haven't seen it this tight in ages, to be fair.
No, exactly.
Where a team... I think we were sixth. It was sixth now. Arsenal? Wolves?
Nah, I don't know.
No idea. But, like I say, it's probably the tightest I've seen it, to be fair, yeah. For a while. But, yeah, we'll see. I mean, obviously, ideal scenario for Man United is...
Yeah, Wolves
place.
Is six, yeah.
Six, yeah.
Fucking never thought about that. So, Wolves, so we got to play... Sheffield who's seventh.
Yeah, you've got hard games, mate.
Wolves at a sixth. Norwich, obviously, bottom.
Yeah, fuck them.
Then top of the league. We're champions.
Yeah.
Fucking hell.
You have hard running, pal.
We have harder.
Really, really hard running. But yeah, we'll see, you know what I mean? Like, obviously, ideal scenario for us is third place FA Cup in Europa League. I'd be fucking buzzing on that, to be honest with you.
Yeah.
Not sure we'll get FA Cup, because we've got to beat you boys, and you boys are, you know, you're playing well, so we'll see what happens.
Bit dodgy in the fence, though, that's the problem.
Yeah, so are we.
We keep leaking goals. We leak goals. You haven't really leaked that many, have you, really?
Nah, just mistakes more than anything.
Yeah, it's more... But us is like, fucking sort it out.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? Rather than... Might be able to get away with that one.
Yeah.
Or if that went in, I'm 1-0 down. Do you know what I mean? But whereas us, like, we're 1-0 down now. Fucking brilliant. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. I mean, I'm just happy. Do you know what I mean? I'm just excited to watch Man United again. And that's a nice feeling. I haven't felt like this since Fergie.
Good.
It's a nice feeling to be back into football a little bit. Because I, you know, sort of lose it. You don't lose interest. Cause I still watch them every week. Do you know what I mean? I watch every United game. I always do. If I can. Yeah. If I'm not working, obviously. And obviously, I went during Mourinho season and that. And all that shit, but you do lose a bit of, not interest, but you just lose a bit of, oh, I can't be bothered. Do you know what I mean? You watch it, but you're like, oh, I'm not in this. My heart's not here at the minute. That's where the phrase saying when you're winning comes from, but fuck them, I don't give a shit. I've been to Old Trafford more times than you've fucking had toast, son, so shut up. Do you know what I mean? But,
well, I've actually been to Stamford Bridge once, so.
Yeah, but you're a Swin fan, aren't you?
Really a fan. Am
Swin
I?
First.
I'm more of a follower.
Follower.
Because the plan was for us was to, like, when Swin were doing, you know, that bad patch where we're not really done much.
Yeah, when you were awful.
And we were like, and then my dad was like, we're not going to get a season ticket, we're just going to get a Chelsea membership.
Yeah.
And go to more games. We never did.
No.
Obviously, because we were like, we could never get the tickets, or we could never, like, the dates would be, you know, like the Champions League ones, but that's a Tuesday night, and we're not going to book time off work for it.
Yeah, I get that.
Because it's like, we don't care.
Yeah.
But, yeah, like, now it's like, I just follow them. Like, if I ever go to London, I might go to the, just maybe the
tour
the, to do the tour. I've never done a tour, actually.
Tour's might good, be
a,
man.
That's not a, actually a bad shout,
do
actually,
it.
For fucking Christmas.
I'm starting to do that.
Christmas present.
Yeah, man.
Ah, sit
that's
down.
That's one of Holly's birthday presents for me. You know that mental weekend she took me on in 2017 when I went to Kasabian on a Thursday? We'll get into that in a bit. Yeah. In Leeds. Stayed in Leeds. Then went to Manchester Friday and Saturday. Went to the May Night Stadium tour. And then on a Sunday, went to go see Liam Gallagher in Nottingham. So,
man, that is mental.
That is nuts.
Why can't I be you?
What a gal. But yeah, the tour was really good, man, to be fair with you. To be fair, you sort of just like wander about, really.
Yeah.
Just fucking have a look. Obviously, our trophy cabinet is fucking massive.
I thought it might be.
It's fucking huge, but
I remember doing the Camp Nou stadium.
Have you done that? Have you?
Yeah, I've done it. Yeah, it's really, really nice.
Yeah.
I bottled it going to the top because I don't like heights.
Yeah, it's fair enough.
Right, but it's just incredible. I can't.
It's mad.
I was literally like, I must have been what? I don't know. 16, 17?
Yeah.
I'm like, this is mental.
That's mental, that mate. That's awesome. Yeah, like, there was always
so nice.
There
man.
Was a business trip in high school where we were meant to go there, and that's the only reason I was going to do business next year, and then they cancelled it the year I went to take business, so I did IT instead. But yeah, that was the way. But yeah, I'd love to go to the cabinet. I probably will at some point. Here we go,
and
to Barcelona.
Like the biggest one I've done,
go on.
Swindon Town Stadium, so.
County ground, under the lights.
Yep, under the lights.
Love that. Love that. Oh dear. But yeah, there we go, that's the football. We're not going to touch it too far, because like I say, you know, just one of them, innit? It's just one of them. Hopefully, we win the rest of our games. I think we've got the potential to win all the rest of our games. And we've got the potential to win two cups. But, you know, we'll beat Chelsea first and see where we are. But one of them, innit, in the FA Cup. Oh, here he goes. Like, ooh.
Sure.
Oh, dear. But, yeah, let's get into some gaming news, mate. Big news for us, this, to be fair.
Big, huge.
One of our favourite co-op games that we play together, Far Cry 5 and Far Cry New Dawn.
Far Cry New Dawn, yeah.
Have announced Far Cry 6. Well, not really announced. It was leaked on the Hong Kong store.
It was. I found it on Twitter first, so therefore I'm cool. Right?
There we go.
But obviously Ryan's done more research because I'm just
more
here
research.
For a good time. So
he's having a great time.
I'm having a great time. You know, you're having a great time. You're having a shit time. Right. So yeah. So basically, Far Cry 6, right, got leaked
in
Hong Kong store.
In Hong Kong store.
I've put in brackets always on island. See, now I've never really played the first one.
They're always on fucking islands.
Like, I've not even played number three. I might even go and play number three because I'm bored.
I think you should. It's a good game.
Do you reckon I'd like it?
It's a really good game. It's a really good. It's probably one of my favourite villains. He's mental.
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
Because I like,
cool.
I just, number five, just, I think it just hit different because I think it's my first one.
Yeah.
And I knew I wasn't going to play it without you. And I was like, well, you know more of the backstory, but then you were like, you don't need to know it because
it's different
all the
time, every
time.
Yeah,
which is cool. Mm. Like, you don't need to have to play it, which is good.
No.
But like, It was really good. I remember
good.
So many times where I'm like, Ryan, if you see any snakes,
right? I remember that, yeah.
You remember that?
Do you remember when we used to spend like 20 minutes fishing?
Yeah.
George, I'm fishing. What'd you catch? Fucking trout. Don't want a fucking trout. Oh,
but I
dear.
Used to get so scared, didn't I?
You like, did, every time,
if I,
snakes.
If I have my headset on and if I hear it, I'm like, oh, I'm not going that way, I'm not going that way.
Rattlesnakes, because you can hear
then,
them really loud, can't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, but then there was a mission, do you remember?
Go on.
Right, do you not remember it? Where we was in, like, that massive container, because we had to get some, like, drugs or whatever, I
yeah,
swear.
Yeah, Bliss,
it was, right?
Probably Bliss, yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. And we had to drop down, and, like, obviously, like, the water was rising.
Yeah, oh,
and we
yeah.
had to go, remember that? And it was,
yeah.
like, crocodiles,
there was
fucking
crocodiles
water
and...
snakes,
yeah.
fucking, I was so scared.
You
that
were shitting
I'm
yourself.
Like,
that was funny.
I couldn't, I'm like, Ryan, you do it for me. I'll just stand behind you, and then, like, I got really scared.
That was brilliant.
That was, like, that is the only mission I remember in my head.
That was so funny. That was so,
there was another one, but I'm not going
to
talk about it.
I used to, yeah, you kill him, fucking Faith, but not talk about it, because... I miss her to this day.
Miss her to this day.
Still miss her. You did the final shot as well. That was so funny. That was like, we were both like, oh, we don't want to kill her, man. It's not her fault. It's Joseph's
fault.
He made her like this. Yeah. I don't want to kill her. And then we had to kill her.
Yeah.
Oh, dear, bless her. But yeah, like you say, they're always set on an island. I think this one's set in Cuba. I think it's a Cuban setting. I mean, the only information we've got so far is that it's the biggest Far Cry playground yet, which makes me excited because I love running around doing random shit on them games.
Yeah.
And it's set in a tropical paradise that's been frozen in time, which does scream out Cuba, to be fair.
Yeah.
I reckon it's going to be a Cuban setting. The villain is actually... I'm reading my notes, by the way, if you see me looking down here. Giancarlo Esposito. Right.
He was in Breaking Bad.
He was in Breaking Bad. Breaking Bad. He was in Breaking Bad. He played Gus Fring.
Breaking Bad.
If you know who that is, if you haven't watched Breaking Bad, go watch Breaking Bad. Good TV show. But yeah, he's going to play alongside. He's going to be called Anton Castillo, alongside his son Diego. And Diego is apparently following in his footsteps.
Is he?
So I think he's the dictator. Like, there's always a dictator in there. There's always someone who's trying to rule the fucking island and all that shit.
I love it, though.
It's
fucking
good,
I love
it?
Joseph.
You know what it is?
Right? I'm sorry. I loved him, I think.
Yeah.
A little bit too
He was a bit good, wasn't he? In New Dawn, he was all right.
Yeah.
Actually, he was chilling out,
then
man.
Didn't he, like, eat an apple and then died?
Yeah, he did, yeah. He was just chilling out.
Oh, sorry
out.
If you didn't...
Nah, fuck him. You know what I mean? Ah, well. But he helped you take down the sisters. So, I mean, he was all right. He weren't that... He was just a bit lost.
I didn't really think New Dawn was overly fantastic.
It
wasn't... It was a bit short.
It was a bit short, wasn't it? Yeah. It wasn't long enough for me. But like, it was more of a side game, wasn't it? More than a game, if you know what I mean, full-fledged game.
Yeah,
could
but
have been
then
DLC.
Again, we need to go and obviously go and revisit Far Cry 5.
We do, and do
pass,
the DLC.
And I need to get the DLC.
Yes, you do.
Like, I need to basically get a disc that works.
Yeah, that'd be great.
So.
Still
going
to download it,
work.
I'm waiting.
Yeah,
I mean,
same.
I'm here.
Same.
I'm here.
So yeah,
we'll definitely do that.
Do, yeah,
yeah, we'll definitely do the DLC for Far Cry 5. Because that'd be great to revisit that. But yeah, Far Cry 6 has been leaked on Hong Kong store. The protagonist
is
apparently...
Is it? 2021
in February, apparently.
February 2021
is coming out. So looking forward to that. Me and George will be co-oping it, probably, on the streams. So check
it
out. Danny Rojas is the guy you play, apparently. He's a freedom fighter.
Daddy Rojas.
Which is not, like I was saying to you before the stream, it's nice to have someone who actually probably has military background, because the rest of them, there was one that was a cop, right?
Yeah.
And then the rest are just random fucking people that are on holiday and end up having to kill people.
Mm.
Like, what the fuck is that shit?
Yeah.
Like, so it's nice to have a bit of a background for this guy.
Yeah.
But yeah, like, Far Cry are just fun games. They're not serious. Like, if you're looking for a serious story game, don't bother. Go play Last of Us or something. But yeah. Great game. They're just fun to play. I mean,
it is really good. It's fun. Like, I want to go back and play like the older ones because I think I might like them.
Yeah,
just
you will. Well, don't start from 3. Do 3, 4.
Yeah, because I was thinking because if you bought the season pass for Far Cry 5, you get number 3 for free.
On PS. Yeah. So definitely play 3 though. That's probably my favorite villain in that one. He's off his nuts, mate. But he's like Raoul. He's like Raoul.
Oh, yeah.
Raoul.
I think I might have maybe watched a little bit of a walkthrough on it.
Yeah. It's really
must
fun,
done.
That game.
Must have done.
It's all about
weed and shit.
You have to destroy a weed farm.
Right. Fair
Good.
Enough.
Good.
Might give it a go, yeah.
It's really good. I'd definitely check it out if I were you. Really good game. But yeah, Far Cry 6, been leaked in Hong Kong store. Don't know how they get leaked. How does that happen?
Because it just got onto the store.
It just comes up.
In Hong Kong.
But what does it take someone to look? Like, is he looking for Far Cry? Like, I'm confused.
No, well, I've looked... Basically, I looked on the thing...
Yeah.
...on Twitter, and there was a couple of pictures, right? And basically, one of the pictures was... I'll find it for you. Basically, like, they've just gone on... Like, you know when it just go on, like, the pre-order?
Yeah.
There was like FIFA next to it and stuff like that. So it does look legit. It looks. So like, if I send you this.
Oh God.
You can have a look. It's up to you. You don't have to have a look.
Where are you sending it to me?
I'm sending it on Facebook.
Ah, cool. I can't
So, yeah. I just thought I'd let you know.
Yeah.
If it just does
I'll
look legit.
I'll definitely have a look at
so,
it. As long as it looks like I say, it looks legit. But the IGN have reported it and stuff, so they must have, good little idea of what's going on. Normally, them sort of leaks are legit, because if they're actually on the store for a pre-order, it probably means that they're getting released soon anyway, like the release date. And, like all next-gen games, by the way, it's going to have a free... If you get it on PS4, you get the free upgrade to next-gen.
Yes.
So if you do get it on PS4 still, that's in cool. February, if you haven't got a PS5 yet, then you can, when you eventually get one, or if you plan on getting one, just get it upgraded and you can play. Obviously, I think I'll probably have a PS5 by then. Hopefully have a PS5 by then. But
I like to think so.
Yeah.
I mean, it does look like I'm going to go down the route of PS.
Yeah.
But at the same time, I don't know.
You got a lot of Xbox games, haven't you?
Yeah.
That's the thing. I don't know. It's up to you, bro. You know. Up to you. We just won't be able to play Far Cry together. That made me sad.
Yeah, well.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I probably will get a PS5 because I've obviously I have moved over to PS now.
Yeah, you have, yeah.
Like fully.
Yeah.
It's just that I've got mainly some digital stuff that, you know, like when you look at your thing over there and you're like, I've only got X, but I've got more than that. I just haven't obviously bought discs.
Yeah.
That's all, really.
Yeah, yeah, that's the thing, isn't it? That is the thing. I mean, eventually I'll probably get both. I don't know. Probably. Maybe. See what happens. Do you know what I mean?
See what happens.
Yeah. PS5 is the way I'm going. Did we speak about? We did. We don't really need to talk about it, to be honest. I was just going to say, for content for next year, innit? We're going to do some FIFA co-op seasons together.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you don't have to, do we?
Just mention
what I mean?
It, innit?
Like, when FIFA comes out in October, isn't it? Right?
Yeah.
I mean, we can do.
We can do. I think we should. Be good, wouldn't
it? I'm not bothered. Yeah.
It'll be good, man.
But the thing is, we'd actually probably stick to it as well.
Yeah. Probably.
Because then it might give you a bit of encouragement. I know you don't want to play it. Like, if you don't, there's like, do a video on it.
Yeah. Oh dear.
Then you can start ranting in the video.
Yeah, can do. Like normal.
Like you did before.
Like I did before.
Or you did it in a separate video, and then you. It's not
there anymore. Deleted it. One of them. Anyway, moving on. Big topic, this one, for me.
I'll let you go with this one, because
I agree with
what you say.
Basically, if you have not, guys, haven't heard this week, big story announced from the band Kasabian. If you don't know who Kasabian are, you've probably been living under a rock, to be honest. You probably do know Clubfoot. There we go. Right, just go fucking YouTube it. Everyone's heard that song. But yeah, Tom Meighan from the band Kasabian, the front man, has been forced to step down from the band due to assaulting his girlfriend during lockdown. He pleaded guilty, has admitted he needs help. He's been struggling with alcohol and addiction for a very, very long time. He spiraled out of control this time, went too far, obviously. He's admitted it, he said sorry to the fans, he's publicly apologised. In his statement, he said him and Vicky are going to move on together in an effort to try and rebuild their relationship.
Yep.
Whole thing, in my opinion, was handled poorly. In terms of, band made a statement before court case finished, right?
Yeah.
Then the court case finished the next day. Then Tom had to make a statement telling his side of the story, right?
Yeah.
That shouldn't happen. No one should be saying fuck all until it's done, right?
Like,
as soon as
done,
that case
done,
is closed and they've agreed what's going on, then you make a statement. Yeah? It was handled very, 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 very fucking poorly. In my opinion. Yeah. It just was. Like, it was a shit show, to be honest. Yeah. I mean, I can't understand it. I think what happened is the media got a hand of it.
They had to say something.
And they panicked. So
they were like, you know what? Let's just get him gone.
Yeah, let's just get. Yeah.
If this is true.
Yeah.
But then we need to go. Like, let's not talk about what he's saying. Leave that till. Once it's all done, but he's already kicked out, which doesn't really matter.
Yeah,
does
it doesn't matter. That's what I mean. Like, obviously, Kasabian made their announcement. Whether it was the actual band, we don't know. It could be just
the PR people.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
They've made the statement. It was worded very poorly as well. It was like, Tom has stepped down from the band because of a number of behavioural issues that he's been struggling with for a long time. And I was and then everyone was like pleading out with their support to him. Like I did. I put a post on Twitter because I thought he was depressed or something, you know? I thought he was struggling for mental health issues because I know he struggles from anxiety and depression, I believe.
Yeah.
He spoke about it before, and
he said it in the statement.
Yeah, I think he did. Yeah, did like anxiety, addiction, and depression. So I was like, "Fuck, okay." I'll put a message on Twitter at people in it and like say, "Hope you feel better soon, and you know, hope you can get the help you need, and I hope you know you get through what you're going through." And then the next day, all this shit comes out, and I'm like, "What the fuck, right?" So that one, it's misled loads of fans. Like Twitter kicked the fuck off, right?
Yeah.
It went mental on Kasabian's fucking news feed, on their feed, and that I was just like, it was so split. Like there was people saying you shouldn't be a band anymore because Tom is half of the band, pretty much. Like him and Serge have been best friends since like they were like 12 or some shit, right?
Yeah.
I don't know if that's true, but something around there, teenagers or something. They've been friends forever, right? And then for that to happen, like I don't get it. It's their two's band, in my opinion. Like as much as because there's only two founder members left anyway, right?
Yeah.
So, in my opinion, I know this is gonna, obviously, if you are a Kasabian fan, you might think differently, because I did see a lot of people saying, well, they should carry on, because fuck that, you know, none of that shit. But they shouldn't, in my opinion, like, if they're...
Those two left, then?
Yeah, it's literally Serge and the drummer.
Yeah, but it was Tom, sorry,
he's a founding member, yeah.
Him and Serge
made the band. Like that was
right.
Okay,
well
band.
Then that's it. Then there's no point. Then is there?
That's what I mean.
What if you're leasing it goes? That's it.
That's right? Yeah. That's like it's Oasis like, carrying on without Noel when he left. You don't do it, do you?
Do you know what I mean? No, you don't. You just don't do it.
I know different circumstances. They had a fight. This is a bit different. He's beat someone up. You know what I mean? He's beat his missus up. But it's same concept. Like, you don't... I don't get it. Like, if the band carries on, I won't be watching their gigs. I won't be going. You know, I'll listen to the music, but I ain't paying to it. I just don't see the point. It's not the same. Like, as much as... He's and the thing is, he's admitted it's bad. He's getting his help. He's gone into rehab again. He's like, he's, I think he's, you know, he's had a wake up.
It's not as bad as it seems, is it? Right,
no.
But it is right, because you say that, you know, the whole beating misses part, right? That is bad.
Of course it is. 100%.
Everything else, a bit positive. It's like he's done it. He's admitted it. We get it.
Yeah,
and it shouldn't happen. We know it shouldn't happen. I'm trying to like stay like be together and stuff. They're working it out and shit.
Yeah, that's what I mean. Like.
Surely, can they still go on though?
That it's hard, isn't it?
Once, let's say, like, you go, you know, we made a mistake. Yada yada.
We know the full story now. Tom's now part of the band.
He's back in the band.
Yeah.
Let's forget about it. Move on. I'll see you 2022.
Yeah. You know what I mean, he'll have a couple of years off, then get back with
what I'm saying,
or whatever.
If,
yeah.
Like, you know. But
would that
be? A bit of a joke, or would you be all right with it?
I think I'd be fine with that.
I think I'd be all right with it, but then again...
This is the thing, though, because I feel like I understand both of it, right? I can, because being in a band, right, our dramas weren't as big as this, right? But you used to solving problems, right, in a band, right? Someone does something fucking stupid, you're all best mates at the end of the day, so you forgive them, right? You give them the benefit of the doubt and say, right, you go get your help, you go fucking sort your head out, right? And then come back and be part of our band, right? We did the same with Hodge, right? He was going through a really bad patch. He didn't come on tour. And I said to him, right, you fucking go sort your life out then. And when you come back, we'll talk about it then. Yeah?
Yeah.
Right? It should be the same here. Like, as much as it's bad and he's admitted it, the thing is, he's done the court case. He's pleaded guilty. He's going to do the community work. He's going to go into rehab. Him and his missus have obviously agreed to fucking carry on together and try to rebuild their relationship.
He's
done everything he can on his part, right? There's nothing more he can do. Obviously, the band, in my opinion, the sensible thing to do is to break up if they're not going to carry on with him, because there is no point. It is him and Serge's band at the end of the day. As much as Serge writes all the songs, Tom's the front man, he's the face, pretty much. Him and Serge have always been the cover of it, right?
Yeah.
It'd be weird for Serge to start singing these Tom-sung songs. Right, it really would be, because Serge has got a completely different voice to Tom. It's not like Liam and Noel where they sound similar, right? In place, that isn't, right? It's totally different, their voices. Serge has got a solo project, right? That he's doing really well.
Do that then.
Go do that, mate. Do you know what I mean? Just go do it. I think it will, in a way, it will piss the fans off. The fan base is going to be split. It's going to cause more problems in the long run. They're not going to be selling out. They probably will sell out arenas, I don't know. But
they
in my opinion,
will,
sales will probably go down. And it's just going to have a really negative effect on the band, in my opinion, because they've split the fan base already by fucking up the announcement. Do you know what I mean? If it was handled better and a bit more internally, where both sides got all of the story before making anything public, then we'd be all right. Yeah. I don't, like, all you've got to do is not respond to Radio X putting their post up. Or we've seen Tom go into court because he, you know, obviously assaulted his missus.
I suppose, you don't need to say anything.
You don't have to
done.
Fucking
I get it.
You don't have to
like,
acknowledge
you don't need
that.
To go, oh, shit, fuck.
Yeah,
people are seeing this. We need to say something. Should we let them go for a bit?
Yeah, that's what I mean. I think there's a very big PR fuck-up, in my opinion.
There's no way... Would he really be at, like... Would he really be happy with that, though? Like, would Tom... Like, obviously...
Go on.
With, obviously, he's now obviously not part of it.
Yeah.
So that was obviously before the court case, yeah?
Yeah, well, apparently.
Was it?
Yeah. Well,
yeah,
apparently,
right?
Yeah, what we've seen anyway, the timeline of it for us is like that.
He's not going to really be happy with that yet, because surely in his head he'd be going like, well, hang on. Let me say my piece first.
That's the thing. This is the point, right?
I don't understand it.
I don't get it, because it was very... It's just all over the place, man. It really is. Like, the thing I was saying to Holly the other day, they're meant to be brothers, right? That band, right, together are meant to be like brothers, right? If a family member did this, right, say I was your brother, well, pretty much am, brothers to the end, we nick that, right? if we were brothers and you did something like that, or I did something like that, I would talk to you first before telling anybody, right?
Yeah.
I would have direct communication with you before anything. It's the same now. We're best pals, right? Same situation, pretty much. We just do streams together, right? Same thing. Might as well be in a band. You can be backup vocalist. Send your Twitter bio, right?
Yeah, it's almost...
I would talk to you first, and you would talk to me first, and then we'd say what we've got to say about it, right?
Yeah.
There's been nothing. I feel like there's not been that direct line of communication.
No.
And the way Tom and his girlfriend are moving on now, then they're going to try rebuild it, that makes me think that it wasn't that bad. And that's really shit to say, because it is bad, but there's got to be two sides to it, right?
Yeah.
I'm playing devil's advocate. I'm just saying, like, I just don't get it. I don't understand it, really. I don't get it. Obviously, it's really bad, and obviously, Tom, he's admitted it, and he's said sorry. He's done all he can. You know, he's going to rehab, like I keep saying. He's going to get help. He's going to do what he's got to do. Going to get his life back on track. I just feel like it was just handled really poorly from media's perspective. But that's the fucking media for you, though, isn't it? Let's be honest. Yeah. They grab something,
really worried about it. Like, you know, when he put the statement, like, or when he left.
Yeah.
I'm like, fuck.
Yeah.
Like, because I'm like, well, is he all right?
That's what I mean. I'm like, what's going on? Yeah.
Please don't.
Yeah.
Don't do something. Come on.
Well, this is the thing. Now it's all come out and that people are worried that he might do a Caroline Flack.
Yeah.
And there was a lot of stuff that was on there saying, I hope you weren't the one tweeting fucking hashtag be kind when you're turning on him now. When Caroline Flack, like, assaulted her husband, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Did exactly the same thing. Got a shit ton of fucking hate for it. Killed herself.
Whereas this one looks a bit more...
Yeah. It's the same case, though, isn't it? Like, if he does do it, then you could see why. Like...
But he don't. He's not
hopefully
going to.
Hopefully won't. Obviously, I'm just saying
he's
it. I'm just being going dark.
Out,
going dark.
It's going to be fine.
Yeah. I mean, right? I hope so, because that would rip me apart. Like, Tom is one of... I mean, it's ripping me apart now on all this shit coming out. And, like, he's one of my biggest influences for being a front man today, you know? Like, he's a great front man. He's great at what he does, man. And he's a great singer, like... And he's one of my biggest influences when I started getting into Kasabian. Yep. And they're brilliant live. Like, I can vouch for that. And it's just shit, isn't it, really? It's, one of my favourite bands has just fell apart in the space of 2 days.
Yep.
At the end of the day. And that's why I'm trying to play both sides of the story. So if you guys are watching this and you're thinking, oh my God, you know what I mean? And I'm trying to be an advocate for that. I'm not being an advocate for that at all. I'm just trying to play both sides of the story, right? Obviously, you know, I'm not picking a side. I'm on the fence. It's not up to me to pick a side, really. It's up to you guys to make your own decision. Obviously, I get both sides. I'm just trying to play both sides, you know?
Yeah.
Just disclaimer. Let's fucking bring the mood up.
Can we?
Move on. We've been going for an hour. That got deep.
Did indeed.
What's up?
What's up? Nothing. I'm just having a look on Twitter, really.
Just having a look on Twitter. Find something positive, please.
Positive? There isn't much, to be honest. Because it's Twitter at the end of the day, isn't it?
Toxic, isn't it? Just toxic. Toxic place. But yeah, there you go. I think that's pretty much the pod, isn't it?
Yeah, pretty much.
That is it. We ended on a very, very dark note there. And I feel a bit bad, to be honest.
Ah, well.
But oh well. It's going to get dark sometimes.
Oh, no, sorry.
What?
Positive news. Sorry.
Go on.
Right? No one cares.
I care.
But in 40 minutes' time, like it fucking matters, the fucking new Swindon sound kit is going to get released. So
hey, there we go.
I'm obviously hoping for a Jerry Yates one, but it's probably not going to sign, but move on it.
Can you imagine if he did rock up, just the video of him walking on screen? Watch it happen.
Because we keep getting outbid.
Guess
who it is? Fucking Oxford. Blackpool.
Oh, Blackpool.
Put more money in. Fucking hell.
Fucking nightmare.
Right, but, you know, we can't afford everyone, so... No, you know,
that's the thing. One of them.
Fucking relegation next year, boys.
Probably.
It really doesn't look good, but I don't want to talk about it.
Top 8, like, though.
It doesn't look good, though, does
George
it?
George said top 8.
Yeah.
So...
But that was back when we actually had players, and now we don't. and it doesn't look promising from the manager interview, but move on,
George. It's all right, do you know what I mean? It'll be okay.
It's okay to be okay.
You'll enjoy League One football next year, either way. You know? Little things.
I would enjoy going.
Yeah, you'll enjoy it. You'll be like, yes, I've seen Swindon League One again.
Yeah, sure.
No.
Nah. It just look good, that's all.
Who's your... Oh, I suppose you don't know your first game of the season yet, do you? Nah. That's not been announced, is it? Fuck, a stupid question, right?
Fucking Oxford gone to Wembley as well, aren't they?
Yeah, they have.
They're going.
Who they got?
Wickham. Wickham in the final.
Damn, that's not good.
Wickham, like... I think they beat Fleetwood, like, 4-1 first leg, and then, like, 4-3-4, I don't know, second
that's
leg.
That's Fleetwood, though, isn't it?
Yeah, Joey Barton, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
Funny.
Oh, dear, that ain't good. That ain't good.
That's it, though, isn't it?
Like
that's
they're
it.
Going up, then, to be fair.
Well, Wickham's just keep scoring.
Nah, yellows, isn't it? Nah, they're best team.
Brilliant.
In the lower leagues. I love them. I think they're well good.
Why?
I really like that one player.
Who's
got,
that?
You know, that striker. What's
his
name? Yeah.
What? Who?
Chris Akabusi. No, I'm joking. I don't know any Oxford players. They're just great. Great
sure.
team. They play good football.
Great team. Do they?
Yeah, they do. Yeah. They do, yeah. I'm actually going to buy an Oxford shirt.
Oh, yeah.
Just to piss you off and wear it on a pod. And you won't know because you can't see me when we do a pod. Do you watch it later? Get a big banner. Oxford till I die. On the wall. Dad'd hate that. It'd be favoured. Well, you fucking get that shit off.
Who's that?
Fucking who's that? Fuck off. Love
never
that.
Never forget it when I come and see you. And your dad goes, who's supporting?
Got a Swindon Town jacket on.
Who are they?
They're good.
Yeah, they're
right. Oh, Swindon jacket, that, isn't it?
Yeah. I just can't believe it. It's like, who's supporting?
Swindon Town. He went, oh yeah, from Swindon, didn't you? Yeah. But sake. Oh dear, but guys, thank you so much. This is it. Do you want an outro or my outro again?
New outro again.
Oh, for fuck.
Carry the pod.
Guys, thank you so much for watching. I apologise for getting a bit heavy towards the end there. Had a bit of a laugh towards the end. We made up for it, didn't we? We made up for it. But like I say, do not take our opinions 100% factual or serious. I'm just going to put a little disclaimer. We do play both sides of the story. We are obviously big respect to anyone who speaks out against any sort of abuse. We said that in the Me Too episode. All that stuff. You guys know our opinions on it. You guys who actually know us know that we're good people. You know, we're not going to fucking say
we try our best.
We do our best, you know what I mean? We have to play both sides. Makes the pod more interesting, doesn't it? Do you know what I mean? We have to play devil's advocate. But yo, thank you so
much. Debate starts going.
Exactly, debates. Exactly. It's what we're here for. It's what the pod's here for. But thank you so much for watching. We do really appreciate it. If you are new around here, remember to hit that subscribe button. Hit the like button. If you smash 10 likes, we'll do another extra bit of content for you.
Bonus.
Bit of bonus. We have to find some more videos to react to. We'll do a tier list or something. I don't know. We'll think of something, won't we? But yeah, thank you so much for watching, guys. This has been the RR and GD Podcast, Episode 5. See you later from me.
Bye.
And a bye from George.
That's me.
Can't say see you later because that's not my outro. Ready? Adios.